Hi, welcome to the screencast. In this video, you'll learn how to insert a new access system and create a sketch. First, begin by clicking File, then New. A box should appear. As we are creating a new part, scroll down and select Part and click OK. Don't worry about the other options for now, we will cover them later. Another box should appear asking for a part name. Type angle bracket and click OK. Note how the screen and the icons around the edges have changed. This is because you're in the part design workbench. Different workbenches have different uses in CATIA. Now is a good time to save the file. By default, it uses the part name. Next, you need to insert an access system, since it is easier to use than three default planes. The access system may not appear as default, so you need to create one. You can do this by clicking Insert and then Access System. A box will then appear asking for definition. Just leave it as the default and click OK. The access system looks a little untidy. You can tidy it up by hiding these planes. To do this, right-click on the plane in the tree and select Hide. You can repeat this with the other two planes. The icons on the tree should now have changed. You can now begin creating a sketch. To make a 3D model in CATIA, you must first create a sketch in 2D. Click the Sketch tool. And start off by sketching in the XY plane, which can be selected either from the tree or axis system. You are now in the sketch workbench. Select the rectangular tool and create a rectangle. But don't worry about the size at this stage. The green symbols that appear are for constraints that have been created automatically. This means the lines are perfectly horizontal and vertical. You can add these constraints yourself as well when needed. Now click anywhere on the screen so that it changes from orange to white. Next, we need to constrain the sketch to the axis. This is good practice and allows you to navigate around your model as the structure becomes more complex. The order is important for the next step, so select the following lines in the order shown. To select multiple things, hold down the Control key while selecting. Then select Constraints Defined in Dialog Box Tool. Choose Symmetry so that the rectangle will be symmetrical about the y-axis. Click OK. In a similar way, select the upper horizontal line followed by the x-axis. Remember to use Control. Select Constraints Defined in Dialog Box again, but this time choose Coincidence. This attaches the upper horizontal line to the x-axis. The next step is to dimension the rectangle. First, select the two vertical lines, again using the Control key, and this time select Constraint tool. A dimension will appear. With this type of constraint, you could also select the Constraint tool first and then click on the lines. This won't work with the Constraints Defined in Dialog Box tool. We need to change this dimension. To do this, double-click on the number, enter the dimension 150, and click OK. Repeat for the horizontal lines. Now that the sketch has completed, you're ready to exit the sketch workbench. You will learn how to convert this into a 3D shape in the next video. Bye for now.